In the efforts of the region, we heard some experience from Montenegro, Serbia, also Slovakia and Malta at this conference. Have you seen some good steps that countries make in that direction?
Yes, the countries that we have been talking about in the conference, like Serbia, Montenegro, they have made the first step towards compliance with IPSAS by saying, first, let's start out with solid cash basis information.
Could you maybe highlight two or three areas where you think you can also be of help and support to the next efforts?
It's important to first have your ultimate objective clear. I think that exists, accrual accounting, IPSAS. But now the question is, where are we and what do we need to do to get there? So, after having developed a gap analysis, what are the differences between where we are and where we should be, develop a plan to get there and get that approved at the highest level.
Don't treat accounting reforms as a pure implementation process. Treat it as a comprehensive reform strategy, including issues of change management. This implementation process is not just an overnight thing issue. It is more about accurately planning the implementation process.
We need to make sure we have information that is transparent so that the citizens, the public, knew exactly what the government is doing.
So we often see in this region, but also more broadly, UN financial reports will just be focused on implementation of the budget. So it will show the budget and the actual spending. But there are many extra budgetary institutions which are not included there, so it's only a part of the picture. Each country in this room have suffered from this problem in the past, and that is expenditure arrears. So those are a direct result of cash accounting. And as Kim said, there's a manipulation in some line ministries where obligations are not registered because there isn't the budget availability. And therefore, stocks of unpaid liabilities arise. And if you're using cash accounting, they're not recorded in the system and they're not reported in the financial statements.
The balance sheets are too weak to resist future fiscal shocks. And that's why even the G20 has decided that governments' balance sheets need to be strengthened. So in order to better manage balance sheets, we need to measure them better. And that's why there is like a strong tailwind now for the international public sector accounting standards that provide guidance to governments in a proper statement of financial position, balance sheet, and a statement of financial performance. So it's not a transition from cash accounting to accrual accounting, but it is making sure that the cash accounting that has always been available is supplemented, completed by proper assets and liabilities information.
You should think of how do you, as a government, as a country, create incentives for accountants, for trainers, for reform champions, not to leave your government once they have successfully completed the TSIPFO course.
Not only do accountants need training, but managers of services, non-financial managers need training. Parliamentarians need to understand. I mean, I've heard the argument that a lot of these guys have worked in the private sector, they understand accrual accounting. I don't think that's necessarily true. I don't think we can guarantee that. So they need some kind of education.
From Slovak experience of accrual accounting implementation, I can say that the implementation is a long process and requires also investment and requires also in workload of public sector accountants, because the benefits are long-term and the benefits are in form of better quality of accounting data, better availability of accounting data, and in form of increased transparency of public finance.